Hello guys, this is Raymond from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 74. The COVID-19 second wave has had a severe impact on India's medical infrastructure. Hospitals are falling short of beds, resulting in admitting only severe or critical patients. Patients with mild and moderate symptoms can remain under home isolation and get treated. However, the patients are likely to struggle sourcing food under isolation, especially when alone. COVID-19 patients under home quarantine can order food via WhatsApp. Chef Sharnash Golia has launched a platform to deliver home-cooked meals to COVID-19 patients. Golia has teamed up with a startup and launched a platform called covidmealsforindia.com, according to India Today Tech. The website has seen some massive surge in traffic within 72 hours of going live. Over 2 lakh users from 300 plus cities visited the platform to find meals. How to order home-cooked meals for COVID-19 patients using WhatsApp. Send a hi to 9888-829-1316 number or the given link in the description. You will then be asked to register as a supplier or a person who acquires food. Suppliers can fill the form and register. If you want to get food delivery to your home, you can just type your area pin code. After you send your pin code, you will see a list of all the nearby food suppliers. You can click on one of the links, which will redirect to you the website, select the place and time slot and book your order. And you can also visit the covidmealsforindia.com website and order food and enter your state and city, tap on find food. You can select the charity food option to get free food. Next, you will see a list of suppliers near you. Select the place and time to book your order. You will also see a WhatsApp logo next to the supplier's name. Tap on it and start a chat and order through WhatsApp. Amazon has paused its annual Prime Day sale in India considering the rise of COVID-19 cases in the second wave. In the past week, India has reported 1.5 million new infections and record daily death tolls as hospitals run out of beds and medical oxygen. Considering that India is battling with COVID-19 second wave, the e-commerce giant has postponed its Prime Day sale in the country. Amazon, however, has not confirmed any rescheduled date for its Prime Day sale. The Prime Day event is held by the e-commerce giant in July to boost sales when we see multiple discounts on products. Global business solution provider IBM has announced that it has created a 2-nanometer chip using gate-all-around nanosheet device architecture. The new transistor setup will enable IBM to fit 50 billion transistors in a tiny space the size of a fingernail. Current high-end chips like Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 and Apple's A14 Bionic uses a 5-nanometer processor. However, the number of transistors that these chipsets can pack in a fingernail space does not exceed 12 billion. This milestone by IBM could prove to be a game-changer in the semiconductor industry. The company says battery life in smartphones deploying the 2-nanometer technology will be greatly improved, up to 4 times the current lifespan of batteries inside phones using 7-nanometer processor. The implication is that according to IBM, your smartphone will only need charging once in 4 days on average. India has held up approval for import of Wi-Fi modules from China for months, driving companies such as United States-based computer makers Dell and HP and China's Xiaomi, Oppo, Vivo and Lenovo to delay product launches in a key growth market. Two industry sources have told the reduced news agencies. Imports from China of finished electronic devices like Bluetooth speakers, wireless earphones, smartphones and smartwatches and laptops containing Wi-Fi modules are being delayed, the sources said. WhatsApp says that it will not delete any Indian user's account that don't accept its new privacy policy. The policy allows the Facebook-owned company to share business information with a third-party application, including its parent company Facebook. Netflix has surveyed some users on a potential new service called N+. According to the report Thursday, that service could include custom playlists for TV series, behind-the-scenes production info and podcast protocol reported. N+ would be an online space where you can learn more about Netflix shows and things related to them. The Netflix survey said, according to the report, one of the suggestions in the survey was N+ to list all the music used in TV shows so users can create playlists, that reporter said. Users can also create playlists of their favorite series and movies. OnePlus under its OneLab has announced a new application called Clip. The new app will let users transfer text, photos and files wirelessly between smartphones, tablets and PCs. Clip also has a clipboard feature that can help you copy the text on one device and paste it on some other device. OnePlus says that Clip app is available across platforms including Android, iOS and Chrome. The company took it as OnePlus community to share the announcement. the Realme Buds Q2 has recently made its way to the global market with a launch in Pakistan. The new pair of true wireless earbuds from the company is launched at exciting colors and price. It has been speculated that the company is going to gear up the launch of true wireless earbuds in India, and we have witnessed a series of rumors about it. In the latest development, TechRadar has revealed the Indian price of the Realme Buds Q2 by leaking the retail box renders. Let's have a detailed look of the Realme Buds Q2 retail box. As per the leaker, the true wireless earbuds will be launched with a MRP of ₹2,499, and the retail box image revealed that it comes with a model number RMA2010. The same model number has been listed on the BIS certification website, recently hinting towards the imminent launch. The retail box live image also revealed that it will pack the main unit, two pairs of extra ear tips in small and medium sizes, a user manual and a micro USB charger cable. It was launched in China with a price of 3999 PKR, that is approximately 2000 Indian rupees. Considering the launch of the first generation Realme Q2, we can safely assume that this handset will be launched sometime in June. Realme has so far launched a couple of V series such as Realme V11, V13 and V15 versions in China. A fresh leak reveals that the Realme RMX3143 phone, which has spotted at the TINA certification platform, could be arriving in the Chinese market as the Realme V25. According to the Chinese tipster, the 2.8 GHz octa-core processor that powers the RMX3143 handset could be the Snapdragon 768G, and this phone may arrive in the Chinese market as the Realme V25. Realtek Semiconductor has just registered a record profit in the first quarter of this year. The news arrives as a networking integrated circuit designer specialist saw its net profit climb to a new high for the fourth consecutive quarter. According to the report, the chipmaker recorded net profits of 3.06 billion new Taiwan dollars, that is $1.92 million, for the first quarter of this year. This marks a growth of 16.4% sequentially and a strong growth of 87.3% year-on-year. Realtek posted an overall revenue of $23.34 billion in the first quarter of 2021, which is a rise of 5.7% on quarter that also marks a new record high. Samsung is also gearing up for the two new foldable smartphones later this year. This includes the Galaxy Z Fold 3 and Galaxy Z Flip 3. As per the certain reports, the former is expected to feature support for S Pen, and now it seems like the future models of the latter might also arrive with this feature. Samsung Galaxy A52 5G India launch seems imminent now, as its support page has gone on the Samsung India website with the model number. The handset originally launched globally back in March alongside the Samsung Galaxy A52 and Galaxy A72, and it could be one of the affordable 5G offerings in the country. Samsung Galaxy A52 5G specifications include a 6.5 inch Full HD Plus Super AMOLED display, Snapdragon 750G processor, and it has a 64 megapixel primary camera, and it runs on Android 11 based One UI 3.0 custom skin. And it also comes with a 25 watt fast charging support, and we should know the Samsung Galaxy A52 5G price in India and availability details when it go official. Samsung announced the addition of Indian English as a part of Bixi 3.0 update. In order to improve the user experience and make Bixi features more meaningful and contextual to the Indian consumers, Samsung has introduced support for Indian English as a part of Bixi 3.0. The new version of Bixi is aimed at controlling daily scenarios through the new and improved Indian English avatar. Bixi can now understand Indian names, places, relationships, context, and recipes. Bixi can also assist users with several things throughout the day. For instance, you can set the timer for your daily yoga routine, check the weather in Bengaluru, call Ma and Bhaiya on your way to work, sharpen your culinary skills with a recipe for chicken tikka masala, and search for Diwali pictures on your smartphone, and a lot more. You can seamlessly connect your Galaxy smartphone to your television set with simple voice commands such as "Hi Bixi, show Bengaluru vacation photos on TV." It will start automatically showing your photos. Twitter has announced the introduction of a new feature called Tip Jar. As we expected, the latter brings the ability for Twitter users to send each other money on the platform without needing to go through a more elaborate process of money transfer. The feature is only being tested right now, so sometime away from getting a wide global rollout for all the users. The platform has not clarified on what basis they are selecting the users that are eligible for the trial, but this selection is mostly like being done on a random basis. HTC might be manufacturing very few smartphones these days, but the Taiwanese company is still going strong in the VR department. It will hold ViviCon on May 11th and 12th at an event. We expect to see two new VR headsets. One of will be a new standalone device called Vive Focus 3 Business Edition, while the other is likely to be Vive Pro 2, a high-end PC headset. Xiaomi will be announcing the Redmi Note 10S smartphone in India on May 13th. The company will be unleashing the Redmi Watch smartwatch alongside it. Ahead of the launch, the product page of the Redmi Note 10S has gone live on Amazon India. At the same time, the handset has also appeared on Google Play console with key specifications. Apart from Xiaomi's India online and offline platforms, the features mentioned on the Amazon listing states that the Redmi Note 10S has an IP53 rated cases, an SAMOLED display with a Gorilla Glass protection, smoother haptics, dual stereo speakers with high resolution audio support, and a 5000 mAh battery within a box of 33W charger, and it comes with a Helio G95 chipset and a 64MP quad camera system. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.